What has become the condition of us? That when women separate from their husbands due to whatever reason, or husbands separate from their wives due to whatever reason, these women feel compelled and they say we never can marry for the rest of our lives because there is a taboo on women getting married again after their first marriage. This is the thinking of Jahiliyyah. This is not Muslim, this is not Islam. Rather, if anything, this came more from the Hindu culture, where a woman will be bound to someone for life. This is not the condition of the Prophet, the Ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The majority of women, all but one, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam married those women who were either widows or divorcees. There's not a taboo in our deen. Why did he do this? To show my Sahaba, the Ummah of the Prophet, my Ummah, until Qiyamah in Cardiff, in Bristol, in Birmingham, in Leicester, in London, in Scotland. Okay, until the day of Qiyamah, this is okay for you, this is halal for you, because Muhammad ibn Abdullah did it. Very sad, where women are now even engaging in ma'adallah in illicit and unlawful relations. So are the men, because it's taboo. We have to keep under the mantle, we have to keep it quiet. We can't say these things in public. Balki people have stooped to that level where they say these things, these topics, they're bgharti. You shouldn't talk about these things in public. Why? Is our deen based on culture? What is our deen based on? Qala Allah, qala Rasul. Allah said yes, Rasul said yes. Khalas. And we have loads of sisters like this. Because our sisters are developing that thought now. Okay, now culture's not in the question. I don't have to be, look, I'm not here to kind of stir the hornet's nest, yeah? But when we live our lives according to Islam, proper Islam, there's wallahi adl and justice. Whatever fasad and fitna you see, it is because we do. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس. Because of your own action, that's why you see problems arising in this dunya. Let's not try and sugarcoat it anyway. Or a sazish of America. Or a sazish of Israel and Yahud. Brother, who made you watch them filthy films at night on your phone? Who made you pick up that weed? Who made you pick up that alcohol? Who made you do that zina? Who forced you to listen to that music? What, that sazish of America as well? That's someone's plan? Whom forced you to do haram? Who told you to do that? Who told you to sit in front of that shaitan box and absorb all the haram?